give of her, don't poke me.
Is that padding?
No, it is the loveliness that is me.
Couldn't you come at something different? It's meant to be fancy dress.
They were giving big discounts on Father Christmas suits at Costume Hire Shop.
I know. I've heard the same story from the 47 other Santas sitting in my pub.
It's not all Santas. I thought I saw a couple of elves in back making toys.
Very funny.
Serves you right for having a fancy dress quiz night a whole week after Christmas.
I'm trying to keep the festive spirit going.
Oh, Jack, you had a tree up in September, a carol concert in November, and a Christmas Eve happy hour every Friday for the last 6 weeks. You've watered down the festive spirit that much, it qualifies as a homeopathic remedy.
Not so funny.
Then you better not go in, gents. I just saw Rudolph drinking that toilet bowl.
Now it's gone from funny to sad. See this?
What?
This is your entry for the quiz.
Oh, hey, Owen.
I don't think so.
You are a bitter and vindictive man, Jack Wake. I thought you'd given up on pub quizzes.
Had to. The old business was corrupt.
So you and Blind Pete haven't patched it up then?
Don't mention that man's name in my pub. He's bad.
Oh, yes, that's right. Remind me, what did the poor disabled man do to incur the wrath of Jack?
He kept winning.
He, the bounder.
He's a pub quiz genius. He knows all the answers.
I say flog him in car park.
The man is a professional. He does a different pub every night, wins all the cash prizes and then moves on. He won last year's grand final trophy and held it to ransom and offered to sell it back to me.
Hey, you got to admit, though, he's dead clever.
No. If he was really clever, he wouldn't have got himself barred, would he?
Good point. Hey, it takes more than a blind pub quiz champion to pull the wool over your eyes.
Exactly.
So, what time's Nicola arriving?
Oh, I don't know. About 8, I think.
Are you looking forward to seeing her?
Yeah, of course I am. But she's such hard work these days. You know, she kind of strips the fun out of everything. Mm. Every time she visits, we have to analyse the strength of our father-daughter bond. Ooh. We used to talk about interesting stuff, but now all we do is examine the state of our relationship.
What sort of stuff did you used to talk about?
Mostly ponies. But she was only 7 then. I'd better go in the back and mark these quiz papers.
Right, you are. Oh, hey, another pint, please, Mrs. Drummond, when you're ready.
I'm going as fast as I can, you drunken doopie.
You know, I envy you, Mrs. D. You can be as grumpy and rude as you like, and no one minds. If I did it, people would take offence. But everyone accepts it from a batty old geriatric bag of bones like you.
Is that meant to be a compliment?
Hey, the highest I can give.
Oh, shame it's coming from a big Jessie dressed up like a giant red gnome. She's not going to be impressed, you know.
She who?
The landlord's streaker bacon daughter. The woman you've been stalking since she was in pigtails. Forget it, pervert. She wouldn't give you a second look if you fell from a tall building and splattered onto the pavement in front of her.
You've known Nicola her whole life, yet somehow I get the impression that you don't like her.
I can't explain it. There are just some people who, for no good reason, make the bile rise in your throat. It's not their fault. It's not your fault. It's just that every time you see them, you want to smash their face in.
Oh, well, as long as it's nothing personal.
Could I have your attention, please? I have the results of tonight's quiz. And to be honest, they're a bit disappointing. Almost as disappointing as your pathetic lack of imagination in the fancy dress department. Still, there has to be a winner. And it's some bloke called Stevie Blunkett. You might know he wouldn't be one of the regulars. Well done, Stevie. You can pick up your prize at the bar. The rest of you, pull your socks up.
Hey, well done, landlord. You've certainly created a merry atmosphere in the pub tonight.
Shut up, or I'll set fire to your beard.
Excuse me?
Yes, sir?
I'm Stevie Blunkett. Can I have prize, please?
You're Stevie Blunkett?
Hey, what? No. Oh, yeah, that's right, I am. That's me, that is. That's my name. Can I have a prize, please?
Just a minute, mastermind. You're telling me that you're the most intelligent person in my pub?
Oh, well, yeah, I suppose, right? I don't like to blow my own, what's the name, you know, trumpet.
All right, nice try. Off with you.
What about prize?
Your prize will be a kick up the arse if you don't skedaddle.
Well, one quiz.
Oh, you didn't. You heard me call out the winner's name, and then you thought you'd come up and collect his prize and bog off home 100 quid richer. No disrespect, but you are the founder member of Club Stupid.
You sit on the throne in the kingdom of Stupidland. You are the captain of the starship Stupid. You are Stupido, leader of the Stew Boys on planet Stupo.
I've got a passport.
My dog's got a passport.
No, Luke.
Stevie Blunkett. Congratulations, sir. Here's your prize.
Thanks.
I don't believe it. Something's going on here. That man does not know the maiden name of Eleanor Roosevelt.
Maybe not, but he made you look rather... what's the word? Stupid?
I have the familiar stench of corruption in my nostrils, and it's not coming from the mouldy mistletoe.
Oh, old dog and partridge, please.
Oh, sorry, I don't know it.
Very funny. Quick as you can, please.
No, I'm serious. I don't know where it is.
You're a taxi driver.
Oh, that's right.
Look, I may be biased seeing as how my dad owns it, but the old dog and partridge is the best pub in town.
So? I only started tonight. It took me 2 hours to find the station.
And what made you think you were cut out for this line of work?
Hey, this is Chobbery. You don't have to do the knowledge.
Obviously. All right, you drive and I'll give you a guided tour.
Hello again, Stevie.
Oh, yeah, right. Hello there.
Perhaps you'd like to introduce me to your mate. Amazing, isn't it? You know, the capital of North Korea and the losing finalist in the 1976 Wimbledon women's singles, but you don't know the name of your mate.
I know his name.
What is it then?
Santa. See? Santa Claus.
Come on, I can see through that Santa disguise. You're Blind Pete.
Never heard of him.
You won the quiz and got this yokel to pick up the prize money.
I don't know what you're talking about.
How many Santas wear dark glasses?
I find the snow very dazzling.
Come off here, you've even brought your guide dog.
That's not a guide dog, that's Rudolph.
Rudolph is a reindeer. That is a Labrador with a pair of cardboard antlers strapped to his head. All right, catch this S-tray.
Ow!
See, you're blind!
I'm not blind, I'm drunk.
Come on, hand over the cash.
No, wait, hey, now you get your hands off me. Take it, if you... This costume's hired, you know.
And here we are at the old dog and partridge.
It looks like they got a bit of trouble.
Get off me, you're completely insane. That's right. Mad Buck Jack. And I'm getting my money back, no way.
Oh no, that's my dad. We never have any trouble at our pub.
Which one's your dad?
That one.
You mean the one who's beating up Santa Claus?
He's not beating him up. He's probably helping him to his car.
He's knocked Santa over.
I think he tripped. Look, he's obviously had too much to drink.
Well, now your dad's kicking him and stealing his wallet.
Look, how much do I owe you?
Hang on, your dad's kicking Santa's dog now.
Hello, stranger.
Nicola, hey. Hey, come and sit down. Hey, did you have a good trip? How are you? You're looking particularly lovely tonight.
Oh, thank you. You're looking particularly red.
Hey, Mrs. Drummond, oi. Get lovely Nicola a drink on me.
White wine, please.
Hello, Nicola. Take it you bought a return ticket.
Nice to see you too, Mrs. D. How's Stan?
Clinging on to life by his fingertips, dragging me down into the pits of despair. Same as usual.
Well, give him my love.
So how's life in Big City? Are you still working for them accountants?
Mortimer and Sons? No, they preferred sons over daughters on their career ladder. I've had five different jobs since then.
Mm. Getting the sack?
To succeed in the metropolitan corporate world, Mrs. D, you have to be flexible.
Getting the sack?
Nice to see Mrs. D has lost none of her joie de vivre.
She's a bottle of laugh, that one.
How's Dad?
Dad?
My dad, Jack? The landlord?
Oh, yeah, he's fine.
What about Matthew? Has he been in touch?
Matthew sent a card all the way from Australia. Mm. First one up in pride of place over the bar.
Mm. Did you get my card?
Oh, yes.
Where is it?
Hanging over the dartboard.
Oh, no. There's a dart hole through my Doves of Peace.
That wine sounds familiar.
Dad!
Hello, love. Good trip.
Fine. Come on, then. Give us a hug. You look a bit pale.
It's winter.
Have you lost weight?
What is this, a hug or a medical examination?
I'm not going to apologise for being concerned about your health.
There's nothing wrong with my health. I'm as fit as a fiddle. I just chucked out a blind man.
I know. I saw it.
Well, there you go, then.
Did you get my present? Yeah.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.